In today's lecture, we are going to discuss about the various instruments used for surveying. So, as you are seeing, these are the instruments which are used for surveying. So, very first is that you can see this is the ranging rod. This ranging rod is made up of GI pipe, galvanized iron pipe, and it is marked alternately in the red and white color, or maybe in black and white color, and also iron shoe is provided at the bottom of this rod so that it can be easily inserted in the ground. These rods are used for ranging. Now, what is the ranging? We'll discuss it later on. So this is a ranging rod made up of GI. Then next instrument is used to measure the length, that is tape. As all of you are aware about the tape, this is steel tape. As you can see, it is marked with the distance in a meter here. Here, as you can see here, this is marking in the below, this is the meter and centimeter, and above it is marked in the feet. So here, after 12 inch, there is a 1 feet, and here it is suppose 30 centimeter, 31 centimeter, like that it is marked. One division is again divided into the 10 division. This is the steel tape, and this is another tape. It is a glass fiber tape. As you can see, also again it is marked in meter one side and in the feet on other side. These tapes are used to measure the distance. Then another instrument used to measure the distance is this chain. This chain is called as metric chain. This is made up of galvanized wire, galvanized steel wire, and each they are bent so that it will form the link, and two links it will form the round shape, and these two links are joined together with the help of these three oval rings. As you can see, there are three oval rings after each link. Here is also 1, 2, 3, there are three oval rings after each link. So this is the link. Each link is of a distance 20 centimeter. So distance 20 centimeter is from, as you can see, between each two links are joined together with the three oval rings. The 20 centimeter length is means between center of this middle oval ring to again this middle oval ring. This is the 20 centimeter. At the end of each at the end of chain, there are two brass handles are provided. This is one brass handle, this is another brass handle to carry the chain. This is the swivel joint provided at the end. This swivel joint is provided so that chain should not twist during its while using it. And again, after, you can see here, after each meter there is one brass ring is provided. And after each 5 meter, there are the tallies. These are, as you can see, these are the brass tally. These brass tallies are provided after each 5 meter length. So this each link measures the distance of 20 centimeter. So for a 20 meter link, how many these links will be there? For 20 meter chain, it is 100. So if this is the chain of 20 meter, this is 20 meter chain. So here it is written 20 meter. So for this 20 meter chain, number of links present, there should be total 100 links should be there. So we can measure the distance by using this chain also. How to measure the distance with the chain, we will see shortly. Again, the next instrument, as you can see, this is the wooden peg. This is wooden peg. At the bottom, it has been pointed so that it can be easily inserted to the ground. It is used to mark the station. Okay, as we have discussed, there are A, B, C, D point. We mark on the ground as a station. So at each station, we fix this peg, and this peg we fix with this hammer. Hammer, you all know what is the hammer, use of hammer. So we can insert this peg to the ground where the station is located. Then next, you can see, this is the arrow. This arrow is made up of tempered steel material, and at the top
there is a ring of 50 mm diameter, and this arrow, this wire is of 4 mm diameter, and this other end is pointed. It is also made pointed to fix it into the ground. So what is the use of arrow? If this is the chain, what is the length of chain? It may be 20 meter or 30 meter. If we have to measure the distance more than 20 meter or 30 meter, then we require the number of chains. So after each chain, we will fix this arrow where the chain ends. After each chain end, we fix one arrow, then we drag the same chain to measure the distance ahead. म्हणजे आपण काय करतो, एरोचा यूज काय, एक चेन संपली, त्या चेन संपल्यानंतर आपण हा एरो फिक्स करतो. तर आपल्याला मग नंतर तीच चेन आपण पुढे ड्रॅग करत नेतो. आपल्याला जितके आहे, मग आपण शेवटी डिस्टन्स मेजर करताना नंबर ऑफ एरोज काउंट करू. नंबर ऑफ एरोज म्हणजेच काय, तितक्या त्या चेन्स तिथे, तितक्या चेन लेंथ आपण तिथे वापरल्या. देन ॲज यू कॅन सी, दिस इज द प्लम्ब ऑफ. दिस प्लम्ब ऑफ इज ऑलवेज यूज टू पॉइंट टू मार्क द सेंटर ऑन द ग्राउंड. इफ वी आर युझिंग, जर आपण कोणतं इन्स्ट्रुमेंट वापरतो, इफ आर युझिंग इन इन्स्ट्रुमेंट टू मार्क द सेंटर ऑफ दॅट इन्स्ट्रुमेंट टू द ग्राउंड, वी यूज प्लम्ब ऑफ. ऑर व्हेन एवर वी फिक्स द स्टेशन विथ दिस पेग, अँड सो वी विल यूज दिस प्लम्ब ऑफ टू सेट द इन्स्ट्रुमेंट एक्झॅक्टली ओवर दॅट स्टेशन. सो वॉट इज द प्रॉपर्टी ऑफ प्लम्ब ऑफ? व्हेन एवर वी कीप द प्लम्ब ऑफ ॲट एनी पॉईंट, इट विल शो यू द डायरेक्शन ऑफ ग्रॅव्हिटी ऑफ द अर्थ. सो इट विल बी ऑलवेज perpendicular to the mean surface of the earth, and it will always directed towards the center of the earth. Ranging. What is ranging? Now you can see here is the one ranging rod, and there is another ranging rod there, as you can see there. Okay. If suppose there are two points, one point is here and another point is far away, as you can see there is another ranging rod is marked. So suppose if we have to measure the distance between these two points, okay, and if the distance between these two points is more than our tape length or chain length, so how can we measure a distance? If we directly use the chain or tape, then is it guaranteed that our distance is measured in the straight line? No. म्हणजे आपल्याला जेव्हा दोन पॉईंटमधला डिस्टन्स मोजायचा, आणि त्या दोन पॉईंटमधला डिस्टन्स जेव्हा एखाद्या चेन लेंथपेक्षा किंवा टेप लेंथपेक्षा जास्त राहील, बरोबर, तर तेव्हा आपण फक्त टेप किंवा चेन वापरला तर आपण ते एका रेषेत सर्व डिस्टन्स मोजू शकतो का? नाही. एखाद्या वेळी आपलं तर टेप इके तिकडे जाईल किंवा चेन इके तिकडे जाईल. तर व्हॉट इज दिस रेंजिंग? रेंजिंग इज यूज टू इस्टॅब्लिश अ पॉईंट इन अ स्ट्रेट लाईन बिटवीन टू एंड पॉईंट. म्हणजे व्हॉट इज रेंजिंग? रेंजिंग इज द प्रोसेस ऑफ इस्टॅब्लिशिंग इंटरमिजिएट पॉईंट बिटवीन द टू एंड स्टेशन. अपोज दिस इज वन रेंजिंग रॉड, सपोज दिस इज ए स्टेशन अँड दॅट इज द ranging rod at a far point is a B station, and we have to establish the straight line between two points. So at the end where the chain is at the chain end, we fix the another ranging rod so that rod will be in the same straight line. That is called ranging. So how do we perform this operation of ranging? So here you can see here I am standing behind this ranging rod. So from this ranging rod I can see the ranging rod, that ranging rod at a far point. So one person will stand behind this rod, and it will ask the another person to move in the line of these two rods. So as you observed that we have fixed one more ranging rod in between these two ranging rod. So as you can see, this is one rod and there are two more rods. So we have established intermediate point. As you can see, the ranging rod in the between these two end points, that is the station we have established. We have established new point which is in a straight line between these two ranging rods. So this process is called as ranging, that is establishing intermediate points between two end points in a straight line. Now next step is to measure the distance between these two points. So to measure the distance between two points, we will use the chain.
So now I will show you how to handle the chain. So there are, while handling chain, we have to fold chain and unfold chain. So how to unfold chain? Just I will show you. So let us see how to unfold the chain. This is the chain. I have hold this chain in one hand, and in another hand I have hold the handles of this chain. Now while throwing this chain, I am keeping these two handles in one hand, and with the other hand I am throwing this chain. So like that, this is the unfolding of chain. So one end we can take drag away. It to make it straight. As you can see, this chain is now unfolded. Now from this point to that point we have unfolded the chain. Now how to measure distance with the chain? Now suppose if I have to measure distance up to this point, okay, so how I will measure? See, this is the chain, start end of the chain. So this is one link, means here it is a 20 centimeter, then here it is a 40 centimeter, then 60 centimeter, then this will be the 80 centimeter, and this is the 100. At the 100 there is a one brass ring attached. So up to this point it is the length of 1 meter. Okay, means these 5 links, 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5, this total 5 links is up to this point the distance is 1 meter. Then again I can measure like this again, the I can count the number of links and I can measure the length up to any point. If suppose I have to measure the length up to this point, you can see this is the brass tally, it is attached here, means here the length is up to this point, the length of chain is 5 meter, because as I told you earlier, the brass tally is attached after every 5 meter. So from this point to this point our distance is 5 meter, and like that I can measure the chain length. Okay, so like this we can measure the chain length. Now we'll see how to fold the chain. While folding the chain, we have to drag one last end of the chain, that is the handle of the chain, to the near end. Now I will carry that handle to this starting point of the chain, and then we'll get the midpoint, and after getting that midpoint we have to fold it alternately. Let us see. This is other end of the chain. I am carrying this other end to the first end like this. Now the both handles are together. Now I will go to the midpoint of the chain. This is the midpoint of the chain. Here is also one tally attached, because it is a distance of 10 meter. So from this again I have to fold this, like one fold like this, other fold is like this. One fold like this, another is like this. Like this. As you can see here, one like here, another here. This like. We can fold the chain. And after this we have to tie this. Today we have discussed how to use this chain and what is the use of this various instrument used for serving, that is ranging rod, arrow, hammer, then plumb bob, tape, and lastly the chain. And also in chain we have discussed folding and unfolding of chain.